this edition, Retiring Rich. I'll be joined by our four money mavens, Phil Town. Let's hand it off to Morning Call.
Good morning and welcome to Morning Call. I'm Liz Claman at CNBC Global Headquarters.
And I'm Michelle Caruso Cabrera here on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange in for Mark Haynes. If you're just joining us, folks, a pivotal day in the markets today. In the early morning hours, a massive violent sell-off in the bond market, pushing the 10-year yield to 5.25%, a move in the bond market that we have not seen in years, pushing long-term interest rates higher. That's the number that helps set your mortgage rates. That's what drives borrowing costs higher for companies. And as a result, it looked like we were going to have a very ugly day in the stock markets yet again. Let's show you what happened with the 10-year yield. Here is the one-week chart. And if you look to the right, you'll see that peak that happened in the early going. But when we got to that level, 5.25%, the buyers started stepping in. If you heard Jim Cramer earlier, he liked it at that level. He liked that yield. And other people did, obviously, too. Let's show you what happened to the Dow Jones Industrial Average so far this morning. The futures looked really ugly, but it almost seems like there was a relief rally as we saw those interest rates pull back. The Dow Jones Industrial Average right now higher by 19 points, 13,285. Can it break this terrible losing streak of the last 3 days where we lost more than 400 points? Right now, the NASDAQ is higher, the S&P 500 is higher by, I can't see the title here, NASDAQ is higher by 3.8, 2,545. And the S&P 500 also rebounding here by 1.5 points, 1,492. In honor of Columbus, perhaps. All right, we have got all of the markets covered for you today. We've got Bob Pisani standing down here on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange. Rick Santelli, where all the very heated action was this morning. Steve Leisman, our economics reporter, standing by because he may have had the interview that helped turn around the bond markets with Fed Governor Michael Moscow. So that's going to be crucial. So, and let's get started. Plus, we've got strategists covering the future of stocks and bonds and what you should be doing with your money right now. Let's get to Bob Pisani right here on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange. It's already very interesting this morning, Bob.
Very interesting and very important here. Right now, bond yields off their highs, and that's certainly the main impetus of why the market's moving forward. Let me give you the terms of the debate as the people down here on some of the trading desks, the stock trading desks, view what's going on here. First, the bear point of view. The bears yesterday, and I got this from a number of emails. Inflation is stronger than expected. The Fed's going to raise rates maybe a little bit later in the year. And secondly, higher rates are going to hurt M&A activity, and that's going to be a negative for the stock market. That's basically the bear position right now. The bull position, and this has been telegraphed by the bulls for weeks now, the Fed is on hold. They are doing nothing. Short-term Treasury yields are not moving up. That's the biggest indicator. And GDP growth has been subpar for the whole last year. The recovery has been slow. No reason to do anything here. And as for the higher rates hurting M&A, most of the bulls say at the current levels, it is not going to affect M&A. They do emphasize at the current levels. Let's take a look at some of the stocks that are moving here. Great day for semiconductor stocks. A little bit of good news. National Semi had some terrific numbers, raised their estimates overall. Looks like that inventory glut of chips used in cell phones and other consumer electronics going away. Texas Instruments is up. I would note Taiwan Semiconductor, one of the biggest contract manufacturers in the world, also looks like they're ramping up production as well. Nice move up there for that stock as well. Kind of quiet day in some of the other stocks, but McDonald's is doing great here today. May U.S. comp store sales up 7.4%. All the restaurants, which have had a tough week, and some of them have frankly not reported great numbers for May, all the restaurants are also moving to the upside here today. We've had a tough week for a number of sectors, but energy stocks has been a market leader for a while. While the market is up today, energy is continuing to move to the downside. I see oil down a little bit here, but some of the big market leaders here, like Sunoco and Valero, which are refining stocks, of course, have had a very, very ugly week. They are to the downside here. Let's go to Rick Santelli. He's standing out in Chicago. And Rick, the bulls have pointed out that the short end of the curve is standing pat. They're saying that's evidence the Fed is not going to do anything right now.
Well, you know, there's always two sides to every coin, Bob. A lot of credit market traders will tell you the reason that the short end isn't doing anything is because this really isn't a battlefield for the short end. What they're concerned about are things like mortgage behavior in an environment of rising rates. You know all about that, Bob. Convexity, adjustments, and that is the battlefield of the long end. And also portfolio sensitivity. As interest rates move up, they need to sell the long end to keep their portfolios at a spot of sensitivity that they're comfortable with, where they don't get longer as prices drop. And as far as the big reversal, while I'm talking, look at intraday twos. And of course, you'll see that dynamic. The yields are actually a little bit below where they were yesterday. But then as you look at 10s and 30s, the reason overnight spikes were the way they were is, listen, these overseas markets are good if you need to tweak your position. We all know that you don't have all the liquidity forces at work, so you tend to see exaggerations. When the yield dropped, it was white as we were coming into our time zone, and the boys have their own products in their own backyard. As for whether you want to buy treasuries, a lot of people saying there's value here, and hey, they might be 100% correct. But remember something, as these rates spike, of course they get exaggerated. The real question is, are we going to go back to the conservative trend of still going up in rates? That's a real debate right now. Liz, back to you.
Rick Santelli, thank you. But I mean, look at just the move this morning from 5.24% on the 10 down to 5.12. Well, Chicago Fed President Michael Moscow, in an interview exclusively with CNBC, suggested that he doesn't think the Fed's overnight lending rate has to move higher to bring inflation down. Senior economics reporter Steve Leisman joins us now with more on the interview that he conducted and the latest economic data. But that swing this morning alone, right after his words, was significant.
And it's only half the story, right? Because we went from 5 to 5.25 back down. Here, there's Steve's exclusive air charts. Fed President Mike Moscow thought to be among the Fed's toughest hawks on inflation. So it is news when he says he thinks the current 5.25 funds rate, if the data behave, is enough to bring inflation down.
What the Fed has said, FOMC's last public forecast, is that inflation would be declining gradually in the coming quarters and over the next during this forecast period. And I still think that that's I think that's the most likely occurrence.
Moscow went on to say that he sees growth returning to trend of around 3% this year. He was not overly concerned with the recent market turmoil, but that he said it could have some negative effect on growth if it persists. Finally, he said he does have some concerns that markets had underpriced risks. Meanwhile, April trade data supporting the idea of a second quarter rebound. The trade deficit coming in at $58.5 billion compared with a forecast of $63 on the button. The March figure was also lowered. That means less of a subtraction from overall growth in both quarters. Strong exports helped bring the deficit outlook, stronger economic growth, moderate inflation, second in the trade data. So now go ahead and trade crazy if you like, but that's what the data show. That's what Moscow said.
Okay, so he's retiring. How nice of him to have been magnanimous and not jar the markets.
No, but he also said that, look, as I leave, I still believe the Fed has more work to do when it comes to inflation. But right now, for his near-term forecast, he's relatively sanguine about the outlook.
Stevie, thank you. Nice interview.
Pleasure.
Stocks opening higher this morning after 3 days of steep losses. A main concern for investors has been the rising yield on the 10-year note, what we've been talking about. But are these fears overblown? What does the future hold as well? Here to tell us are Jim Hardesty, President and Market Strategist at Hardesty Capital Management, and Jack Ablin, Chief Investment Officer at Harris Private Bank. Good to have you both on, especially a day like this. Jim, 10-year hits 5 yesterday, just brushes 5.25 this morning. Is this a key signal, something to worry about, or much ado about nothing?
I think it's probably a little bit of that. I think we've seen pretty much the peak here.